Hello students, welcome to a new class of skill education and we are going to do IT 402. We had completed the last unit, that is the unit on electronic spreadsheet, in our last video. Today we are going to do our last unit, that is the unit on digital presentation. This is our last unit of the chapters of IT 402. In previously we have done the first unit, which is IT enabled services, our second unit on keyboarding skills, the third unit on digital presentation, fourth unit on electronic spreadsheet, and this is our final unit on digital presentation. Now, under digital presentation, we are going to cover the next suite under the OpenOffice suite. We are going to cover the next package, which is called as OpenOffice Impress. Now, the previous ones were OpenOffice Writer and OpenOffice Calci. Now, OpenOffice Impress is similar to PowerPoint presentation, and we can create good digital presentations with the help of this particular software. So, let us look at the parts and the layouts of this particular OpenOffice Impress window and see what are the slides and what are the different layouts and how different it is from PowerPoint presentation. So, let's get on to the chapter.
OpenOffice has a presentation software called as OpenOffice Impress, which helps us to make presentations very easily. It is similar to the on the grounds of Microsoft PowerPoint, which is an open or which is in the Microsoft Office suite. So let us look at how we go into presentation. Click on the OpenOffice software and double click on the presentation. Now here there are three options which opens up an empty presentation. We can open a presentation from a template or open an already existing presentation. Now when if I click on the template option, then many different templates are available which can be used to create already ready-made presentations. Now templates are ready-made presentations where we just need to actually enter the data at the places where it is provided. But here we are creating today an empty presentation or a new presentation. So I click on empty presentation, click on the next tab. Now here there are certain designs which are available which can be selected from where we can. This is basically the design or the layout of a presentation that we want. We can select any one of them or make our own design later on. So here now I am just clicking on a simple blue border presentation. Next, I can click on certain slide transitions effects here right itself at the beginning. I can do it so that it will be available to all the slides. If not, I can do it later on. So now, as of now, I am not giving any effect or any speed. We can even control the speed of the transitions from this area, that is slow, medium or fast. If I select any of the different types of transitions, I can do it. Slide transitions means the way one slide comes on to the during the presentation, one after the other. So that is called as the slide transition. So wipe left, wipe right, and the preview of it also can be seen to you here. Once it has been selected, whichever I want to, I can select it, and I can also control the speed of my presentation, the transition. Now here, once that is created, I click on the create tab, and the create button helps me to create the presentation. And here a new untitled OpenOffice Impress file is created, which has got the ODP extension. Once a file has been saved, an Office Impress file gets the extension of .ODP. Now here, let us go on into the actual layout of an OpenOffice Impress window. The first bar is called as the title bar. Again, it gives you the name of the presentation that we will save. The next bar is called as the menu bar, which contains the file, edit, view, insert, format, tools, and the slideshow options, which contain different options which help us to work with our presentation. The next bar is called as a standard toolbar, which contains some of the most commonly used options which we while working on the presentation. For example, the cut, copy, paste options, or the spell check, print options, file saving, opening options, and also inserting certain objects and changing the slide design, slide layout. All this is available to me in the standard toolbar. And below that, we have the formatting toolbar, which gives us the different formatting options available. Now, this window, this area on the left hand side is called as the slide pane, where all the miniature of all the slides which are available, which we create, are given. This is called as the work area, which contains the single slide, and on the slide we have the placeholders where we can type and enter the matter that we want to put into our presentation. On the right hand side is the pane, which is the task pane, on which the different options are available, that is the master pages, the custom animation, the slide transition, and the gallery and the navigator. Now, once I have my slides are available, I can do all the necessary formatting from here. I can also change the slide layouts, like changing of the slide layout, like there are many different slide layouts which are available, and I can change them from here also. Now, the next one over here is the drawing toolbar, which helps me to insert certain drawing objects into the slide. I can insert the objects like the rectangle or ellipse or the basic shapes, symbols, text boxes, and also pictures from the gallery using this drawing toolbar. We also have the slide in OpenOffice Impress can be opened in 5 different ways, that is the viewing, that is the normal view, an outline view, the notes view, which helps me to add notes to my slides, the handout view, which helps you to take a printout of the miniature of the slides. This is a very important one where you can actually take printouts of the different slides, and a slide sorter view, which gives you thumbnails of the different slides which are there. As of now, I have only one slide, so it gives me only one. The normal view is the view in which we can do all the different types of editing possible on our slide. Now, if I want to insert a new slide into my presentation, I can click on the insert and slide option, and automatically when I say, the different types of layouts which are available will appear to me over here in my task pane. I can select the title slide, the blank title, the title slide, title and content, title only, title and two content, and many different types of layouts which can be used in my slide. So I have to decide according to my presentation what type of, for example, the first slide is always generally the title slide, and after that I can select the slide and change the layout according to my presentation what I want to. So I can click on, also I can click on the right click on this area and click on a new slide, that also helps me to give. Now here I can, when I select the title and two content or title and content or any other text, then depending upon what I want, I will get the layout. So here it is exactly similar to PowerPoint presentation. Now here I can click and insert tables, charts, insert any movie clips or insert pictures, or also I can write bulleted text in my presentation. So this is basically this is the basic slide layout of the OpenOffice Impress presentation screen. Now, once my presentation is ready, I can click on the file and save option, that is Control plus S, or save as option, or I can also export my presentation into a PDF file or export it as an HTML document. So these are the two different options which are also available to me: export as PDF, so my entire PowerPoint presentation becomes a PDF, or also I can export it and make it into an HTML document. So I can save it in any of the different formats, that is a BMP and many other formats in which I can save my presentation. PDF format, an HTML format, or an XHTML format, or any of the different formats which are available, I can save my presentation. That means I can export my presentation into all these different formats. The next thing that, so this is called as a placeholder. A placeholder is a place where I can actually type my text. So if I want to make a presentation on pollution, I will click on the title slide and I can write it as pollution. And from here, I can also insert any text box in a blank area. I can insert any type of artwork or frame or word art options from here. Any of them, I can click on that. And here, I can edit the text and write whatever I want to over here in this particular option. Now, I can also insert some pictures from files or from the pictures option if I want. I don't have any of the pictures right now, but on my desktop, if I want any pictures, I can do that pictures and I can insert it in any of the area which I have. Now, there is not much of a option here. I don't have a good picture, so I'm not inserting it, but I can also take pictures from the different gallery. All this has already been taught to you in your Word, so, but suppose if I want to click this and right click and insert, then the picture gets inserted onto my slide. So here I have got the word art which I did, and here is my picture. So this is, and also I can insert some symbols or any other type of options from my drawing toolbar. This is very simple, this everybody knows, and all the different types of options available for changing the colors and changing the background, all is available to you on the right hand side. You can increase and decrease the width and the color and all options for any selected object. So basically, once this is ready, you can start making your presentations how you want to using the OpenOffice Impress software. It is very simple. It is just like the normal PowerPoint. Now, regarding the slides, by default, there are certain activities which we can do on the slides also. By right-clicking on the slide, we can insert a new slide, we can delete a slide, or we can even rename a slide. We can change the slide design and the slide layout. Now, if I want to change the slide design, I can click on this and select any other slide design of my choice and change the slide design. I can also rename a slide. From here, renaming of a slide means by default my slide is slide number 1, 2 and 3. I can rename a slide. For example, this slide, I'm renaming the slide as introduction. So I write introduction. So my slide name is introduction. So when I move my cursor around over here, it will tell me that the slide name is introduction. So like this, I can right click and rename my slide, and I'll write, let's take second slide. Second. So this is the name of my slide now. It is no longer slide 1. It will be shown as introduction slide. And here the next slide is slide number 2. Can you see here introduction second? So here instead of slide 1, slide 2, it will be shown to me as introduction and slide second. Now here, when I click over here, I can also have a hide slide or start the slideshow or a duplicate slide. A duplicate slide means the same slide will be, again, I can use the same slide, so I get a duplicate slide. This can also be done from here. Now, I can also change my transitions, hiding slide, cut, copy, paste from right-clicking over here. Or I can do the same options from the slideshow menu. Slide transition and custom animations can be done using this particular option from the slideshow menu. So, these are the basic options which are available to you under the OpenOffice Impress, with the help of which we can make good presentations. So here, let us go to the the OpenOffice PDF, which is available in the IT402 PDF, which I've already downloaded from the CBSE website. You can do that, and your presentation software will contain, that is the entire chapters will contain the OpenOffice. As I told you, we are using OpenOffice Impress instead of LibreOffice, but the entire layout is the same. So here I already showed you what is this, what are the parts of the Impress window, and the edit file, edit and insert options, the format, slideshow, and the standard toolbar, the slide pane, workspace, the slides, the task pane, the master pages, the different layouts, the table design, custom animation, slide transition, the drawing toolbar, the insertion point, and the status bar, zoom control. I also showed you about how to create a presentation with file new and how you can use templates to create the presentation, and also the different slide layouts, that is the title slide, title only slide, and adding text to a slide, and how to save a slide is in OpenOffice Impress. You can save it with Control plus S or save as Shift plus Control plus S, and how you can save it in the different other formats other than the ODP extension. Now also how to run a slideshow and how to save a presentation with, and how to export it as a PDF file or an HTML file. This is all what we have learned in today's chapter. How we are working with slides, how to create duplicate slides of the same one, how to insert a new slide, and how to rename a slide. That is what we have done. There is also another option which we already know, how to cut and paste and copy and paste to create the shortcut key of Control plus X, Control plus C, and Control plus V. This we have been doing very easily, and how you can also drag and drop to copy and move the slide. So these are the different, and how to delete a slide. Okay, let us go back and see copy. And so if I click on a slide and I drag it down, I can get moving the slide from one place to the other. I can just simply click it and drag it, and it will take me to that. And if I want to make a copy of the same slide, I will click, keep my control key pressed and drag it down. So it will give me a copy of the same slide. So that is, or I can also right click and say copy and come up anywhere and right click and paste. So I get a copy of the same slide. This also can be done by keeping pressing it and keeping the control key pressed and then moving it around, then I can get a copy of the same slide. So this is basically what we have learned, and renaming also. I also showed you how to rename a file and moving, deleting and copying the contents, that is using control C, control X. This is what is in to be covered in today's chapter. And in the next time, we will learn the different objects that we can insert into a slide and how we can run the presentation.